With two-person rope teams in particular, but also with three-person teams, brake knots are recommended when conditions are not ideal, like if you're descending on very hard fern or in poor visibility. These brake knots should be tied in the middle third of the rope length, not too close to the first member of the rope team, nor to the second or third, because the rope first needs to cut into the snow. The brake knot will then act as a chock in the groove cut into the fern by the rope. When climbing in a rope team of two or three people, it is essential to tie brake knots in the rope to help arrest a fall. In this case, it is important that the brake knot bites into the edge of the crevasse, slowing the fall of the climber. The recommended knot to use is the overhand knot, a knot used frequently in mountaineering. Alternatively, you could use a butterfly knot or a double overhand knot. The simplest brake knot is the overhand knot. You tie it by making a loop in the rope, then take the loose end round the back and up through the center. This is a simple knot that has the major advantage of always turning outwards. This means when you drag the rope across the glacier, it offers the least resistance. So if you're walking for hours, it is really helpful that it doesn't keep snagging on objects. As a brake knot in your rope team, you can also use the butterfly knot. This is actually a bent knot that has the advantage that it helpfully turns outwards on the ice or rock. This means that it doesn't get caught on obstacles. The easiest way to tie a butterfly knot is to wrap the rope three times around the palm of your hand, then pull the middle strand beneath and through the front strand, back over all three strands, and then under all three across your palm and out the other side. Now when you pull on either end, the knot tightens to create the typical shape of the butterfly knot. Another type of brake knot is the double overhand knot. This is the bulkiest of the knots. To tie a double overhand knot, you first tie an ordinary overhand knot, leaving it relatively loose, then take the extended loop right around the front of the knot and up through the center of the knot a second time. This results in a large, bulky knot. When using brake knots, you generally tie three brake knots between individuals in the rope team. In other words, one knot in the middle of each rope length, then two more knots on either side of this one, and 2 or 3 meters apart. And that is generally sufficient to create the additional braking effect in the event of a fall into a crevasse. Brake knots are very effective for small rope teams in particular, or if there's a significant weight difference between rope partners. For this reason, our advice is to practice, practice, practice. Then you'll be quick, the knots will be precise, and you can work with maximum efficiency.